Tell me on the best diet. I'll be feeling like your sign. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Oh my gosh, it is fall now and we're starting to cool down. So let's jump right in. I just have my nice little throw-on shawl, pink awareness for cancer awareness October. So where were we? I discussed on the last video insurance, because insurance is coming up and you have decided to do the surgery. And before that, I gave y'all the nice video of my surgery day. And I want to get right back on track. And we're going to discuss how to handle going home during the post-op phase. This is going to be some great information so you can get an idea. There is phases in post-op. You have phase one and phase two. So in this video, I'm going to be discussing phase one. I will also attach some VSG post-op friendly recipes as well. You will see that on my channel under the VSG recipes. And these are post-op friendly broths that you can incorporate while you're in post-op phase one. So let's jump right into it. So I came home from surgery, and the first week, I would say it was tough. Any type of, let's say I was nauseated, the pain levels, it's about a 10 for the first 3 days. My surgery was that Monday, and then I came home on Tuesday. And I would say all the way to Sunday, my pain levels were between an 8 and 10. By Thursday, I was walking regular around the clock for 30 minutes. And I was just pushing through the pain because I wanted to get rid of all that gas. Like I told you earlier, walking at this point, and that is it. Walking is going to help you with healing. So I'm going to give you some tips to start off when you're going home. And you guys know I've got my notes. This is my package. So I'm giving you verbatim with Lone Star Bariatrics. And they give you and they take care of you so well. And I just wanted to share it with you all to get an idea. So first of all, you really want to be patient with your body. You just went through, for some people, this is major. For others, it may not, but either way it goes, it's still surgery. So be very patient with your body. During the first 6 weeks after surgery, you will be on a bariatric progressive diet, starting with liquids with 3 weeks of soft and 3 weeks of like prevent any surgical complications. So I hate to be the bearer of bad news. As much as you don't like the pre-op diet, surprise! You're on a liquid diet 3 more weeks after surgery. So all in all, you're on liquids for about, you have 2 weeks, and then 2 weeks after the pre-op, because your diet is following Monday from the 2 weeks. So I'll say about a month and a week. So about 1 month to be exact. 2 weeks plus 3 weeks, so 5 weeks. 5 weeks, people that want to count. A month and 1 week, you're on liquids. But y'all know this is because of your surgery. So that's why it's very important to follow that pre-op diet. There is a reason behind that. All right, number two, please follow the dietary phases. Please. Please. Don't experiment when you get home with this surgery and be like, you know what? I'm going to try this, or I know this is work. You know, remember, this is a tool. And for this tool to work, you want to follow your doctor's orders. I know everybody loves to experiment on what works best for them. In the past, apparently, we got the surgery because we failed in the past. And it's okay. We're seeking out for help. But with the help, you have to shift your mindset and focus on, this is going to help me. So look at it from that perspective. Number three, do not rush to go back to work. I haven't really touched on this. Everybody's journey, everybody's job status. I would honestly say do what works best for you individually. I will give an opinion. If you go on short-term disability and they allow you a set of weeks up front, I would use all of it. And that's my opinion. And I'm going to keep it right there. This is different. This is going to be a whole life change mentally. Your body's going through it. You've got to get used to it. Plus, you have to tell yourself you're not your old self again. So I would take all the time off as needed to get better. So I definitely would not rush. But for those who cannot use a long, lengthier time, prepare yourself now to take off extra weeks. But the shortest amount of time that they will tell you, you just need 2 weeks of recovery. It's very short, but that's your call of how much time you need away from work. All right. Number four, have friends and family help you. This taps on my life. Y'all go take a look at my last video of getting myself together, putting things in place for surgery. I got my house in order. I got bills lined up. This is very important because when you come home from surgery, you're not going to be that energetic. You're going to be tired. You're going to be fatigued. You don't know how your body is going to react. You just don't. So having systems in place like meals in the freezer, your bills paid up, or your bills set up on automatically, however system you have set up. If you have friends and family that can step in, help with cleaning up around the house, grabbing a couple of groceries for you because you're out. Or you can use DoorDash or any type of gigging economy, Uber Eats, y'all know Grubhub, anything that's close to you to bring it to your doorstep. All those will help you. Because you really need help afterwards. You really do. Okay, number five, you want to focus on your fluid intake. This is going to be now a chore because before then you was upset because you couldn't eat. Now you have to force yourself to eat in a form of liquid. So you want to focus on your hydrating fluids and you want to be drinking every 15 minutes. So you want to set your timer for 15 minutes. You're going to use your 30 milligram cups and you're drinking your fluids. While you're intaking these fluids, there's a list and I'll go over that list. But the key is everything is sugar free, everything. So that would be water, sugar free water, enhancers, Propel Zero, etc. So you want to make sure everything is room temperature or cold, whatever suffice best for you. but you really want to focus on your fluids for the first phase. Okay. Number six, do not drink carbonated beverages. No Cokes. Your stomach will tell, I promise you. And I know y'all thinking, Trina, did you drink Coke? Nope, I didn't. You know why? Because I made a decision that I was going to follow this diet because I do not follow nothing in the past. That's why I got it. And plus my stomach, when I freshly came out, I told y'all it was hard for me to do that this cup right here. 30 milliliters. It was hard for me to drink water and keep it down. So there was no way I was tapping into carbonated beverages. I just wasn't having it. But hey, you want the tool to work, follow. All right, number seven. Come on, guys. No alcoholic beverages. They have to say this for a reason because we just think we can swing it. But it is very important that you don't consume alcohol for 3 months. No wine or alcohol. And beer is also carbonated, and that shouldn't be consumed either. And the reason why, because the alcohol affects your liver. And remember, you just shrunk your liver 2 weeks prior. And that's not going to be on the safe side, okay? So look at it from a healthy standpoint. I just want to just let you know. The alcohol affects liver very quickly after surgery, and it's causing serious liver damage, okay? I did do my research, and plus my doctor told me. And it can also cause weight gain. Oh my God, y'all, it's full circle. Like, why would you do that to yourself? It's bad nutrition. And your girl drinks alcohol. I'm a wine connoisseur, but yeah. That was the first thing I was like, oh, no liquor? Okay, cool. I'd rather eat than drink. That's been my motto, but I will survive without liquor. So, for those of you who need a time frame, 3 months. There you go. And those who want to extend it longer, you can extend it longer, but 3 months. All right. Number eight, do not chew sweetened chewing gum. Y'all know I don't like gum. I don't even like bubble gum. So this was not something that bothered me. They just doesn't. So if you do need gum, make sure it's sugar-free. Sugar-free, there goes that word again. And make sure you don't swallow your gum. Y'all, we learned that as kids. Don't swallow gum because we know how long it takes to digest. Ew, gross. But yeah, sugar-free gum. For those who want to chew gum, sugar-free. Me personally, I had retainers, and it was Invisalign, so I couldn't chew gum to begin with. I have to do mints, and for me, I just did sugar-free mints, so another idea. Number nine, remember to take your chewable multivitamins, B12, your calcium, and antiseptics every day. You may need to take additional supplements like vitamin D and iron if prescribed. Now, this is definitely on an individual basis because your doctors know your vitamins and prescriptions that you need. This is individual and they'll let you know when to start. Me, to be exact, I was able to start my multivitamins about 6 or 7 weeks post-ops. I'll have a video on that about vitamins. So everybody's different. Everybody is different. So that's just something that you want to remember just handling while you're home. Just stay on top of it. Number 10, exercise regularly. In phase one of your post-op, that's starting out with walking at least 10 minutes a day and building up and then gradually going. That's it. Number 11, measure your food servings. Phase one, you're on liquids. So right now you'll be focused on your protein intake and your water intake. That's the only thing you'll be focused on. And my intake for my protein, I had to get 64 ounces of protein in daily after surgery. So after surgery, it was just broth, protein, and water. So 64 ounces of protein, 60 ounces of water. That is the main focus during phase one. Number 12. When you are graduating to food, eat and drink slowly. Do not use straws. Why? Because you're going to put air and liquid in your stomach, and your stomach is on the small side and you don't want to fill it up with air. You want to get the water in your stomach, so drink from your cup. Okay? That's when you graduate to foods. And number 13, stop drinking fluids with your meal. This is where I struggle with the most. This is very different for me. I remember when I went to my dietitian years ago, she gave me this rule and I never followed it. She was like, never drink your meal with your food. Focus on chewing your food nice and slow. Drink your beverage after your meal. Okay? There's a reason to this method, you guys. Now, with this surgery, you really have to put that in place, because mentally, you're not prepared that your stomach is small. It has to catch up with your brain. So eating and drinking at the same time will catch up with you. So the rule is, when you graduate to foods, you drink a half hour before your meal. Excuse me. You don't drink fluids a half hour and at least a half hour after your meal. So, for example, if you're planning to eat, let's just say breakfast at 8 a.m. in the morning, make sure you drink water or whatever beverage. If you want coffee, have your coffee between 6:45 a.m. and 7 a.m. Okay, the net 15 range. So let a whole hour go by and then have your breakfast at 8. And just have your breakfast. Okay. Let 30 minutes go by. This is where your timers are gonna come in. And you can schedule to drink something about 45 minutes to an hour later after breakfast. This was an extreme hard task. And I'm being real with you guys. It is still to this day a challenge for me, because there's just days I forget, like, oh my gosh, I can't eat and drink at the same time. Your stomach will let you know, I promise you. So practice that now. Practice that now. Those of you who are seeking dietitians or nutritionists, that is a rule that they have been saying forever, but it's real once you get the surgery. It's very real. Last tip, do not force feed yourself at this point. Use this time, try to develop an eating pattern or routine. Whew, where do I get started with this? I can honestly say I grew up, we don't leave nothing on the plate. That's one thing. Also, we believe that if we leave food on the plate, we're wasting our money. We don't want to waste our money. So that plays a part. Y'all, this surgery, your stomach is going to tell you we are full. And I promise you, if you go past that, it's not a beautiful ending. Your stomach will hurt. It's very uncomfortable. You can throw up. It's not a good feeling. So listen to your body. That's the whole reason why you got this tool. So the whole small meals, eating 3 to 6 times, welcome. This is where you're really going to have to plan out your meals and get it in, because you don't want to run or risk the fact of not getting your food, your nutrition in. Then it's working against you and you'll be hitting a stall. And I will discuss stalls with you guys. It's so real. It's the same thing. It's no different. Just because you got the surgery doesn't mean it's not going to stop you from stalls. Install means that you're not losing any weight. You're just stuck. Some of you know it as a plateau. It's the same meaning. But in the VSG community, they call them stalls. You will not succeed if you do not put yourself on an actual regimen. Put a system in place. So if you eat 3 small meals, when you get to phase 2, because you're going, you know, that's when you're introducing foods. In the phase 2, it's going to be soft diet and half of the 20 to 30 grams of protein shake with about 100 to 200 calories between meals as a protein power up. And your goal of proteins is 60 to 120 grams. So you don't want to worry if your protein is low in the early phase after surgery. Just try to lose 50 grams a day. That was a lot. We'll go over that in phase 2. But this is where I was telling you guys, those are all the tips. But let me give you a little side note. Do not in phase 1, and phase 1 is weeks 1 to 3. Okay. Do not go back to your old habits. Do not open MyFitnessPal or the Noon app or whatever you've been writing notes on, taking count. This is not the time to count calories because you're only on liquids. It's going to really throw a curveball because some of you are going to drop significant amounts of weight and it's not going to make sense to you at all. Your mental is going to start like, that's not normal, because that's what we know. But you're figuring out it is normal if you've had this surgery. It's very normal. Is it, people have asked me, is that safe? Yeah, it is. You all are different. It depends on everybody's body, you know. Also, scientifically, and I'm not a scientist, I'm not a doctor, but I do, you know, all of us that's been trying to lose weight, we research the heck out of stuff. The bigger you are, the more weight comes off faster, quick. The smaller you are, it takes a little bit longer to drop the weight. So if you are bigger and you're on liquids for 5 weeks, yes, you're going to drop a lot of pounds. Why? Because we're only drinking and we're doing water and protein. And I found out protein is sufficient for me, and that's how I'm losing my weight. When the longest, I didn't really believe that it happened, but I'm finding out protein is the way for me to lose the most significant amount of weight. And I've lost a lot so far. But please remember, in phase 1, do not even go down the whole macros and calorie count. Your main focus is drinking liquids every 15 minutes. Y'all, it's a chore all day while you're up walking, getting your broths in, because these 3 weeks, you're not going to want to do it. You're not going to feel up to doing it. The first 3 days when I came home, y'all, I was in my bed right behind me. I got up to go to the bathroom and I came back. I was out of it. I had to set timers to take all my medication. I had to set timers to drink water. And there, hey y'all, there was a day I didn't even drink. There was a day I just didn't feel like it. So I just want to give you reality. Like, it's not easy. I know some of you thinking like it's nothing. No, it's not, because mentally you have to prepare yourself. You can't eat the way you used to eat. And then now you're going a whole nother 3 weeks on liquids. Okay, so enough about that. I'm now going to let you guys know during phase one what your liquid diet is for the first 3 weeks. They welcome all clear liquids. And everything is full liquids. And I know we've been on beef and chicken and bone and vegetable broths for 2 weeks now. And I know you're sick of it, because I was sick of it. Seriously. So I have some broth with a twist, 15-minute broths, that I'm going to attach for the post-op phase. And I beg to say you could do it in your pre-op, but don't do it. But when I look back, you really can, because there's nothing. It's just broth. So I believe you can. I'm pretty sure you can. So I got an etouffee broth and I've got a gumbo broth cooking video. So check those out. So you're on full liquids. And what you drink, sugar-free everything, sugar-free, decaffeinated, non-carbonated, and it has to be less than 15 calories per 8 fluid ounces. Start with your 30 milliliter cups and then graduate to a cup. So look at your schedule, set it up, drink, okay? You're gonna need your water. If you don't like water, do water enhancers, crystal light, anything that says energy labels, make sure it doesn't have any caffeine on it. So I just stuck with my low sugar, no sugar, sugarless packets. I just made sure everything was sugarless. You want low sodium chicken broth, beef broth, vegetable broth, everything low sodium. You could do Propel Witness Zero water, Powerade Zero, sugar-free popsicles, yay. And you can do your different proteins. And I'll have a video on different proteins. I end up doing Isopur. No, you can do Isopur, but I did the GNC brand because, as you guys know, I hated protein drinks and I dreaded it, but I stopped listening to myself and saying I hate something and I just pushed through. So I really got creative in different types of protein shakes. So I will add those as well as time progresses. And I will share that in the VSG recipes. That's it. In phase one, you just want to make sure you're getting your liquids in at this point, weeks 1 through 3. You want to stick with a schedule, walk for 10 minutes, and take all your medication around the clock. And focus on the grams of protein along with that water intake for your liquids. You want to get that in every day. I want to thank you guys again for tuning in. Thank you for the wonderful feedback, the text messages, the calls, the inboxes, the comments. Please like and subscribe. Turn on that notification. And I do apologize. I did not drop last week. I'm dropping these videos this week. And you're going to get about 3 because I'm going to be dropping the cooking videos as well. So, sorry. My camera is running low. Good thing this video is coming to an end. Until next time, I want y'all to have a wonderful week, and I will be talking to you next week. Bye.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. So tell me that.